Good afternoon. Good to see you again. Just like my cousin, Prof. Singh, but many other dignitaries, Prof. Gar, Trivedi, Madhushudan. You see, Ben Man from Bengal, I'm Bengali name. Madhushudan is a Bengali poet, very famous Bengali poet. And of course, Rizwan. It's very nice to be here. I said this morning, this is my second visit to DTU. First was at DCE. He became DTU many years ago. So again, I'm a pretty old man, here for a long time. My first reaction to this day, beyond the temperature issue, is the enthusiasm I see in your eyes, in your smiling faces, that you are not bothered with the heat. You are happy to be here, enjoying the company, and I hope you keep this interest for the next 6 days. I'll be here with you every day for 6 days. So, first of all, the GAN program is a global initiative for academic networking. I want to extend that. Academic includes industry as well. I was with Mr. Sinha at NBPL yesterday. He's very interested to learn how we solve certain problems because we have some way of dealing with industry. In the US market, working with industry is almost a requirement. I have worked with 1, 2, 3 power companies as I progressed in my life at Virginia Tech. Duke Energy, C-Panel, to a collective power company. I was at NBPL yesterday. I met 5 colleagues from Capco that are working there when I used to work almost 20 years ago now. So my point is life is not one direction. Many things happen. So young generation, I would welcome your thinking, be open-minded, be creative, be patient, and be hopeful. To win out at the end. In my case, when I was doing my B.Tech in Bangladesh, my goal in life was to become a tea garden manager. A goal in life. Because at that time, tea gardens managed by British companies, like James Finley and the like. And the big thing was, you go to England every year on vacation. UK company. That's a big deal for me. So I went there, gave a job interview for the Finley company, and they asked me in the interview, what's your goal in life? I said, I have to be a tea garden manager. He said, wait 15 years, not now. So that was too long for me. So I went back to academia, went to US in 1974 for my master's, PhD, all of that. But I learned over time that life has different directions, different opportunities, and if you're patient, you'll get there. My other goal when I began a teaching career at Texas A&M first, I was 28 years old. I had only 2 journal papers at that time from PhD work. So my goal in life was to publish as many papers as my age. So I'm 28 years old, 2 papers, right? I'm 26 deficit. How we make it up? So I work very hard. Now I've got more than 100. I'm 100 years old. So one is be patient, work on it, and by virtue of hard work, I guess, you'll get it. So that's for my younger colleagues, that you can be a businessman, businesswoman, engineer, MBA, whatever it is. But I have 3 children. They're all grown up. I think my son is older than this one, most likely. So, Indian families in the US, they almost force their kids to be a doctor engineer. Almost force them. My guess, no. First is an economist, second is a social scientist, third is a finance major. So I asked them, why don't you go to engineering or professional thing? They say, you and my dad work very hard, you will make enough money. So I said, fine, if you want to be an economist, businessman, and they're all doing well, by the way, it's not bad. So point is, I don't tell my students at Virginia Tech what should they do. My PhD students, I have 12 of them now. Only one from India, IIT Chennai, and they can go to academia,
work in industry, or go to national labs, or I come back to India, whatever it is. So I tell them my job is to make you think openly, independently. And I challenge my students, this is my advice to them for younger generation here. I said, if you hear something, do not repeat it without thinking what it means. It's very common practice, young people. Hear and repeat, hear and repeat. I said, you have 2 years in your mouth, use that more than your mouth, so that you can be a valuable partner. I've seen it all my life. If you give a meeting, give a talk, I listen very carefully, so that I am not making a mistake of repeating without knowing what's going on. So my advice to younger generation, also mid-level managers at NTPL as well, that ask questions. And my focus is, I would like to train my students to ask the right question. In many cases, people don't know what questions to ask. If you don't know a good question, you'll never get a good answer, for sure. So, first thing is not the answer, is the question. And ask the right question, you have to know the surroundings. What is the situation going on today? So that's the main thing. And GAN program, I'm a Bengali, so GAN means knowledge. What I noticed here, Saraswati, she is a goddess of education. When I was growing up in East Pakistan at the time, the big thing was not Diwali, Saraswati Puja in Bengal. Highly regarded. So, my grandfather was a lawyer, and his thing was education, big deal. And those Indian families in US, UK, you see in the US market, you have a spelling bee contest, spelled for 8th graders, 30 years old, 40 years old kids. 80% of the cases, Indian kid wins this because of family training. So you have the right background, right motivation, and I hope you take that into account and make it the next thing to do. You may not make as much money as you like, but money is not the only thing. Point is, you get satisfaction doing what you want to do. Then money will come. So I tell my friends, I don't want to be rich, but I want to be famous. If you're famous, you're happy. Rich may or may not come. So again, the young generation, ask good questions, be patient, and never give up hope that I cannot do that. So with that, I'll stop here. It's getting pretty warm here. But I'll be here with you for 6 more days, and you can get hold of me, ask questions. I published my email address in there. Will you write to me so that I can read your email in the subject line? Say, I met you at DTU. Then I'll be for sure. Otherwise, I may ignore it because I get so many emails every day. So I'm very happy to be here, happy that we are able to communicate, happy that you are taking interest in this course, and I will do my best to explain what I know next few days. With that, thank you very much.